Hello, welcome back to CODT and FIB-DM. Now, you probably watched a lot of the tutorials, semantics for data architects and so on already. Now, this is something completely different, data models for ontologists. And I give a short overview of the configurable ontology to data model transformation, CODT in reverse mode. With CODT in reverse, you can transform entity relationship models into RDF OLE, and by doing so, you accelerate your design of the enterprise ontology for knowledge graph and other use cases. So the FIBO and FIB-DM are the industry standard. The EDM Council now markets the FIBO as the open knowledge graph. It's a blueprint for enterprise ontologies and the knowledge graph. 1,200 users already downloaded the ontology-derived financial industry business data model. And the patent-pending technology that created the FIBO data model is available for licensing. The intended audience for this video is the Semantic Center of Excellence that has to build enterprise and operational ontologies. So you could be an ontologist with FIBO expertise, data architect experience in enterprise reference model, you know FIB-DM, you know, of course, your existing databases and models. And as a stakeholder, you want to accelerate semantic enterprise information architecture. So there is a chasm between semantic and conventional data management. That chasm impedes FIBO customization. So the ontologist here has an extensive reference domain ontology. However, the financial institution must still customize the FIBO. The data architect has models of existing databases, maybe even enterprise data model based on FIB-DM. The ontologist cannot leverage conventional information assets in the data modeling tools. The organization has metadata for new open knowledge graph modules, classes, and properties. But then the ontologist must still manually type in hundreds of classes, copy and paste it. And CODT in reverse is the bridge across the chasm. So the vision is Semantic Enterprise Information Architecture, SEIA. And when we look at architecture models, we can look at them by the use type and the level. And we have data models, logical, physical, deployed on RDBMS. And we have other models for message process object in the enterprise. So newest, we have the enterprise knowledge graph, the FIBO in RDF OWL, residing on RDF databases. And FIB-DM is the logical data model. Now, what CODT performs is a bi-directional transformation between the ontology and the data model. Bidirectional transformation enables SEIA. So left-hand side, we see the FIBO, enterprise knowledge graph, operational ontologies. On the right-hand side, we have FIB-DM, enterprise and project models. So we generate data models from industry domain and our proprietary ontologies. We design conceptual models in RDF OWL. And we reverse engineer our data models to extend the enterprise and project ontologies. Yeah, and this is the path for midsize being updated now, and the years are indicative. So suppose you are here in beginning of 2021. You already adopted the industry standard and you want to move on to SEIA. The proposition is that for the ontologist, it's easy to learn a new language, OWL, and the tooling if you already know the content and design. For the ontologist, it's easy to build FIBO ontologies if you have FIB-DM data models. So what does CODT in reverse do? Here's a data model to ontology mapping. On the left-hand side, we have a data model. Right-hand side is the ontology graph that we want to generate out of the model. And for that, we have a transformation and mapping. So data model entities become ontology classes. Subtypes become subclass properties, associative entities, and relationship convert to object properties. And finally, cardinalities to class restrictions, and not depicted here, attributes become data properties. So how do the bidirectional COD metadata sets work? On the left-hand side here, just have a symbol for Power Designer, the modeling tool, right-hand side, the bird for the ontologies. And the transformation is a basic ETL, extract, transform, and load. In the MS Excel, COD implementation uses Microsoft Power Query and the Microsoft M language. First step is, in the data modeling tool, we create list reports and we can populate the tool-specific, in this case, Power Designer metadata sets. Then we transform this into a generic, independent of the particular modeling tool version, and we transform it into an ontology metadata set, and then we can use Sparkle Construct or bulk load to populate our. Yeah, and here's a code demo. I have an example logical data model in Power Designer, just a few entities taken from the New York Stock Exchange Open MDM. And in Power Designer, Irvin, or any other tool, I can create list reports. So here, just for entities, I want to report the code, name, and the comment. In this report, I can save as a CSV. And then I move over to COD. And here's a Power Designer metadata set. It's basically, it's an MS Power Query that just populates our entity MDS from the CSV. And I end up here then with code, name, comment. So from the tool-specific MDS, we go over to the generic representation. It just again populates from the Power Designer MDS. We have a name, we have a comment, and what we must configure is what we want to have as a prefix and the base URI. From there, we head on to the ontology metadata set, and there, here the class basically it's a concatenation of the prefix and the entity name. And then we have the namespace and the SCOS definition populated from the entity comment. And now here I have some special tabs. T here, the prefix stands for triple. So in order to load into the ontology, we need the data in terms of subject, predicate, object. So here, this takes it from the classes MDS and breaks it down into triple, auction, type, owl, class. And we have the same for the SCOS definitions. Then finally, in the our ontology editor, in this case, it's a top grade. So I just can copy these triplets and just wrap a Sparkle Construct statement around it. When I execute the construct, it has six triples as a result set, and I can assert these selected triples. When I do that, it creates classes in my ontology. And likewise, I can do the same here for our annotation properties. I execute the query, and I assert the triples. And then when I look at the class, here the auction, now I see the class is created, and it populates the SCOS definition. And the same way we can transform, reverse engineer object properties, data properties, and we can do it here for six entities, or we can do it for an enterprise data model with 600. Well, thank you for watching, and yes, just send me an email if you have more questions or like to do a POC of COD. And you also can find more information on the FIB-DM website, the YouTube channel, or follow the news and discussion on LinkedIn. Thank you.